Welcome you again to my channel, that is Nursing Gyan. Today we will discuss under increased pulmonary blood flow fourth defect. The fourth defect is atrioventricular canal. Under atrioventricular canal, first we will see the description. Before description, just let me highlight the structure and parts of the heart. This is right atrium, this is left atrium, this is right ventricle and this is left ventricle. So as you know, these are the two upper chambers, these are the two lower chambers. In particularly atrioventricular canal, if you see, it's incomplete fusion of endocardial cushion where there is lower ASD continuous with higher PSD, and even you can see the clefts in between tricuspid wall and bicuspid, that is mitral wall, which makes a complete canal. If you see, which makes a complete canal at the center of the heart, where the blood flow can be with all four chambers. Usually, the direction of the blood depends upon the pulmonary and systemic resistance. Usually, the blood flow is always from left to right because left-sided pressure is always high compared to right. You see here, the first blood from right atrium will go to the right ventricle. The high pressure left atrium will also flow towards the right ventricle, and as you know, left sided ventricle is more pressurized than right ventricle. It will also flow, or it will also direct its blood towards the right ventricle. At the end, there is an increased right ventricular pressure. So this is where you see there is a big canal. So this is what atrioventricular canal is all about. Next, moving towards the hemodynamics. In hemodynamics, flushed blood from superior vena cava and inferior vena cava will come to the right atrium. From right atrium, blood will go through tricuspid wall, it will go to the right ventricle. From right ventricle, it will go to the pulmonary artery. From pulmonary artery, it will go to the right pulmonary artery, left pulmonary artery. It will come to the left atrium through pulmonary veins. Once the blood comes to the pulmonary vein, little amount of blood will flow towards the left ventricle, but maximum blood flow is towards the right ventricle. And third thing, whenever blood goes to the left ventricle, because of increased left ventricle pressure, it again pushes blood towards the low pressure right ventricle. So if you see here, the right ventricle is completely pressurized because of all other three chambers, and there is increased right ventricular pressure, and that puts pressure towards the pulmonary artery. So pulmonary artery pushes pressure again towards the lungs. So that is why this particular atrioventricular comes under increased pulmonary blood flow condition. Next, we will see the flow chart of this. If you see, superior vena cava plus inferior vena cava, it will push the blood towards the right atrium. Right atrium pushes the blood towards right ventricle through a tricuspid wall. So after right ventricle, the blood will go to the pulmonary artery. Through pulmonary artery, the blood will go to the lungs. But once from the lungs, when blood comes to the pulmonary vein, this I have marked with the oxygen, like red color, because it is now oxygenated. The blood from pulmonary vein will go to left atrium. From left atrium, the normal mechanism is that the blood should go to the left ventricle, then to aorta. But because of this particular canal from left atrium, some amount of the blood will go to the right ventricle also, and some amount of the blood again through left ventricle, it will go to right ventricle. If you see right ventricle, this is also right ventricle, this is also right ventricle, this is also a right ventricle. From three ways, blood will come towards the right ventricle. Because of this RV3, that is threefold increase in the blood, it increases pressure in the right ventricle. So right ventricle increases the pressure in the pulmonary artery. So that is why this will come under increased pulmonary blood flow condition. So this is the hemodynamics related to atrioventricular canal. Next one is clinical feature. Among clinical feature, you can see the first one is that mild cyanosis while crying. You can see mild cyanosis because there is a mixture of deoxygenated and oxygenated blood, which a baby may not get adequate amount of blood. So there is a mild cyanosis we can see while crying. Second one is loud systolic murmur. You see, because of all these three chambers, the right ventricular chamber is completely filled with the blood, and whenever it contracts, it makes a loud systolic murmur, because systolic murmur is because of that particular contraction. You can see right ventricular hypertrophy because the pressure will increase. The threefold pressure will increase in right ventricle because of right atrium, left atrium and left ventricle. Fourth one, you can see pulmonary hypertension. Pulmonary hypertension is mainly because of increased right ventricular pressure, which puts too much pressure towards the pulmonary opening, and because of that the right pulmonary artery and left pulmonary artery will have too much increased load, which it cannot bear, that can lead to pulmonary hypertension. And lastly, this particular pulmonary hypertension can lead to congestive heart failure. So these are all 5 clinical features we can see in atrioventricular canal. Next one is diagnosis. Under diagnosis, first we'll do history collection. We'll ask the parents related to their genetic history, any exposure to the radiation or any maternal factors that has contributed to atrioventricular canal or not. Next one is physical examination. Under physical examination, we can see the mild cyanosis and loud systolic murmur through a auscultation. Next one is we can do ECG, electrocardiogram, that is to see electrical activity or action potential within the heart. Next one is Holter monitoring. Holter monitoring is usually done to know the blood flow patterns, because here if you see the blood flow patterns are very complicated here, because the right ventricle has high pressure and from right atrium blood will go to the right ventricle, from left atrium blood will go to the right atrium, from left ventricle blood will go to the right ventricle, and sometimes the blood flow may reverse. Means usually first left side to right side the blood will shunt left to right, but once the blood is very high in the right ventricle, the blood flow also may revert from right to left in some conditions. So Holter monitoring is very necessary to assess all the blood flow patterns for 24 hours. Next is angiography. Angiography is usually to visualize whether there is obstruction in tricuspid and bicuspid because of the cleft formed by this atrioventricular canal. And the last one is cardiac MRI. Cardiac MRI is usually done to see the splices, where exactly the defect is present, what is the cleft size, what is the lower ASD width, what is the upper ASD width, where there is exactly canal. To see all these things, the cardiac MRI is necessary, and this is related to the diagnosis. Proceeding towards the management, under that surgical management. In surgical management, as you know, the atrioventricular canal is related to the lower ASD. The lower VSD is first closed with the Dacron patch, and upper VSD is also closed with the Dacron patch. And if there is a necessary, there is a reconstruction of the valve is done, so that totally the center part is completely reconstructed, so that the blood flows within the heart will remain normal. So the first management is septal patch closure, and second one is valve reconstruction. So if you do this, the baby may remain normal, but there are many complications to it. there may be always chances of leakage of the blood. There is a chance of like blockage. Once the, if at all the closure or the patch, if it opens by mistake, there is always a chances of a blockage also. And there is, if there is a blockage, there is a pulmonary hypertension also, and there is a chances of congestive heart failure. So these are the like surgical management related to atrioventricular canal.